Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Today I'm working on some feathers on my Handy Quilter Infinity. Now, I am not good at feathers. I find them a bit intimidating, and I don't think I'm going to be really good at making elegant looking feathers anytime soon. But there are lots of variations with feathers, and I have come up with one that I think is fairly easy to do and kind of fun, and it doesn't really matter if you're perfect or not. And so that's the best part when you're quilting. If people can't see that you made mistakes, or what you might consider a mistake, then that's a good design, right? So what I want to do is I want to come up and make my spine like you normally would do, with a little loop at the top, then come down, then go up one side and go up the other. But instead of making perfect little feather shapes, what I'm going to be doing, I'm just going to draw my spine here, come up here, and we'll make a loop at the top. But I want to take my feathers, what are going to be my feathers, I want to come up and I want to start with the round shape you usually do and come around, but then I want to hook in and then come back down. So it's sort of like a little paisley or something like that. And then you're going to come up and do the next one. So that's sort of what I'm going to be doing one side, then the second side, and then I'll show you what I'm going to do next. So I want to leave a little bit of space in between each of my feathers because I'm going to go back and fill in between there. So let me get started here and show you what I mean. So I'm going to go up, I'm going to go all the way up the spine, and I'm going to make a loop at the top. Then I'm going to come back down that spine. I'm not concerned that I'm not on the line here. If you want to mark your spine, use a water-soluble pen or a friction mark or something that will come out later on. If you don't hit it right on, it doesn't really matter. I'm also not concerned with going right back over there. As a matter of fact, you can intentionally leave space, and that's great. You're going to be going up and down this spine. You're not going to be able to see it later on, so don't sweat about that. Now I'm going to go up and make my first feather. Okay, there's my first feather. It's off what I drew. That's okay too. You can vary the size of these or try and keep them all the same, whatever you want to do. I'm going to continue on now, back up the spine. Okay, so I've done feathers on the one side. They're kind of different sizes and stuff. They don't look like normal feathers, but that's okay. They will look better by the time we're done. Let's start and fill in the other side. Keep in mind, one side will be easier to do than the other side. It seems to be that way for everybody. Okay, so when I've done my feathers on this side, what I want to do is I'm not going to go back down the spine. I'm going to start filling in now, and I can start at the top, so I might as well. I'm there anyway. What I want to do is I want to add some just swirls, sort of like little ferns, in between these feathers. And I also want to fill in inside some of the feathers as well to give some more interest. So I'm going to start here. I'm going to put a little swirl just in this area. Okay, I'm not too concerned whether I go back on the same line or not. Again, if you intentionally don't want to, go ahead and do that. I'm also going inside the feathers and putting a little swirl inside there. I'm not going to do that with this little guy because he's kind of thin as it is, so I'm just going to leave him, but I will put a little swirl in next to him. I had a bigger space in here, so I actually put another little swirl in there too, so you can either fill in the area if you want. And that's what I decided to do. And so that's sort of my feather. It's a funky kind of feather. You can see there's quite a bit of thread build up in here. I'm using a 40 weight cotton right now. So I would probably go to something thinner than that, depending on how big I made my feather, because there's a lot of thread, build up on the feather. Just take a closer look at it here. So you can see what it looks like. Now you can still see my drawn design, but it doesn't really matter. But it gives you a very organic shape to fill in. It's very easy. I'm just playing with it. I'm not stressing at all about it, how it looks. If I want to go back in later and fill in some areas, I certainly can. Or you can just leave it as it is. But give it a try and just have fun playing with those kind of organic feathers.